Need a simple, practical intro to LIN bus? In this guide, we introduce the Local Interconnect Network, LIN protocol basics, including LIN versus CAN, use cases, how LIN works, and the 6 LIN frame types. Note, this is a practical intro, so we will also look at the basics of LIN bus data logging. Keep watching to fully understand the LIN protocol. First of all, what is LIN bus? LIN bus is a supplement to CAN bus. It offers lower performance and reliability, but also drastically lowers cost. In the following, we list some of the key facts about the LIN protocol. First, LIN is a low-cost option, ideal when speed and fault tolerances are not critical. It is often used in vehicles for windows, wipers, air condition, etc. LIN clusters consist of one master and up to 16 slave nodes. LIN is based on a single wire, plus ground, with 1 to 20 kilobits per second, at max 40-meter bus length. The LIN protocol uses time-triggered scheduling with a guaranteed latency time. Further, it offers variable data links, 2, 4, 8 bytes. LIN also supports error detection, checksums, and configuration. The operation voltage is 12 volts, while the physical layer is based on ISO 9141, aka K-Line. Finally, LIN supports sleep mode and wakeup. It is often useful to compare LIN bus versus CAN bus. In the following, we list some of the key differences. LIN is generally lower cost than CAN bus, less harness, no license fee, cheap nodes. CAN uses twisted, shielded dual wires of 5 volts versus the LIN single wire of 12 volts. A LIN master typically serves as a gateway to the CAN bus. LIN is deterministic rather than event-driven. In other words, there is no bus arbitration. LIN clusters have a single master, while CAN bus can have multiple. CAN uses 11 or 29-bit identifiers versus 6-bit identifiers in LIN. CAN offers up to 1 megabit per second versus LIN at max 20 kilobits per second. In short, LIN bus offers a useful alternative to CAN bus that can serve different use cases. To understand the origin of LIN, let's briefly look at the history. In 1999, LIN 1.0 was released by the LIN Consortium, BMW, VW, Audi, Volvo, Mercedes-Benz, Volcano Automotive, and Motorola. In 2000, the LIN protocol was updated, LIN 1.1, LIN 2.2. In 2002, LIN 1.3 was released, mainly changing the physical layer. In 2003, LIN 2.0 was released, adding major changes. This version is widely used today. In 2006, LIN 2.1 was released, while in 2010, LIN 2.2A was released, a version that is now widely implemented. Further, in 2010 to 2012, SAE standardized LIN as SAE J2602 based on LIN 2.0. In 2016, CAN and Automation standardized LIN as ISO 17987-2016. Looking ahead, LIN serves an increasingly important role in providing low-cost feature expansion in modern vehicles. As such, LIN bus has exploded in popularity in the last decade, with 700 million nodes expected in automotives by 2020 versus 200 million in 2010. To better understand how LIN bus is used in practice, let's look at real LIN applications. These include various automotive use cases like the following. The steering wheel cluster can include cruise control, wiper, climate control, and radio. A comfort cluster may include sensors for temperature, sunroof, light, and humidity. The powertrain can include sensors for position, speed, or pressure. An engine cluster may include small motors, for example, cooling fan motors. The air condition may involve motors and the control panel, which can often be complex. In the car doors, a cluster may involve side mirrors, windows, seat control, and locks. In the seats, a cluster may involve position motors or pressure sensors, while other automotive use cases include window wipers, rain sensors, headlights, and airflow. Further, LIN bus is also being used in other industries, for example in home appliances like washing machines or in industrial automation, for example manufacturing equipment. To provide a practical example, we can consider the interaction between LIN and CAN in window controls. In particular, LIN nodes are typically bundled in clusters, each with a master that interfaces with the backbone, CAN bus. As an example, in a car's right seat, you can roll down the left seat window. To do so, you press a button to send a message via one LIN cluster to another LIN cluster via the CAN bus. This triggers the second LIN cluster to roll down the left seat window. To better understand this functionality, let's look at how the LIN bus works. LIN bus, at its core, is relatively simple. A master node loops through each of the slave nodes, sending a request for information, and each slave responds with data when polled. However, with each specification update, new features have been added to the LIN specification, making it more complex. In the following, we cover the basics of LIN frame and the six LIN frame types. In simple terms, the LIN bus message frame consists of a header and a response. Typically, the LIN master transmits a header to the LIN bus. This triggers a slave, which sends up to 8 data bytes in response. To understand the LIN frame, let's look at each frame field. Break. The sync break field, SBF, aka break, is minimum 13 plus 1 bits long, and in practice, most often 18 plus 2 bits. The break field acts as a start of frame notice to all LIN nodes on the bus. Sync. The 8-bit sync field has a predefined value of 55. In binary, 010101. This structure allows the LIN nodes to determine the time between rising, falling edge, and thus the baud rate used by the master node. This lets each of them stay in sync. Identifier. The identifier is 6 bits, followed by 2 parity bits. The ID acts as an identifier for each LIN message sent, and which nodes react to the header. Slaves determine the validity of the ID field, based on the parity bits, and act as follows. Number 1, ignore the subsequent data transmission. Number 2, listen to the data transmitted from another node. Number 3, publish data in response to the header. Typically, one slave is polled for information at a time, meaning zero collision risk, and hence no need for arbitration. Note that the 6-bit allows for 64 IDs, of which IDs 60 through 61 are used for diagnostics, more below, and 62 through 63 are reserved. Data. When a LIN slave is polled by the master, it can respond by transmitting 2, 4, or 8 bytes of data. Since LIN 2.0, the data links depend on the ID range, ID 0 through 31, 2 bytes, 32 through 47, 4 bytes, 48 through 63, 8 bytes. Checksum. As in CAN, a checksum field ensures the validity of the LIN frame. The classic 8-bit checksum is based on summing the data bytes, LIN 1.3, while the enhanced checksum algorithm also includes the identifier field, LIN 2.0. For details on this, see our full LIN bus intro article. Importantly, multiple types of LIN frames exist, though in practice, the vast majority of the communication is done via unconditional frames. Note also that each of the below follow the same basic LIN frame structure, and only differ by timing or content of the data bytes. In the following, we briefly outline each LIN frame type. Number 1. Unconditional frames. The default form of communication where the master sends a header, requesting information from a specific slave. The relevant slave reacts accordingly. Number 2. Event trigger frames. The master polls multiple slaves. A slave responds if its data has been updated, with its protected ID in the first data byte. If multiple respond, a collision occurs and the master defaults to unconditional frames. Number 3. Sporadic frames, only sent by the master if it knows a specific slave has updated data. The master acts as a slave and provides the response to its own header, letting it provide slave nodes with dynamic info. Number 4. Diagnostic frames. Since LIN 2.0, IDEs 60 through 61 are used for reading diagnostics from master or slaves. Frames always contain 8 data bytes. ID 60 is used for the master request, 61 for the slave response. Number 5. User-defined frames. ID 62 is a user-defined frame, which may contain any type of information. Number 6. Reserved frames. Reserved frames have ID 63 and must not be used in LIN 2.0 conforming LIN networks. For more on this and advanced LIN topics like the LIN node configuration file and LIN description file, see our full LIN bus intro article. To finish off, let's look at LIN bus data logging. Recording LIN bus data is relevant across a range of important use cases. An example, logging CAN LIN data via a hybrid logger is key to OEM vehicle development and can be used in optimization or diagnostics. For example, it can be used to ensure that prototype equipment is communicating as expected. CAN LIN data from automotive prototype equipment can be collected at scale using IoT CAN LIN hybrid loggers to speed up research and development. This is particularly helpful if the LIN clusters need to be evaluated during practical in-field usage. Industrial machinery can be monitored via IoT CAN LIN loggers in the cloud to predict and avoid breakdowns via prediction models. Further, a LIN logger can serve as a black box for industrial machinery, providing data for, an example, dispute handling or rare issue diagnostics. If you have a LIN data logging use case, reach out to us for free sparring. You may also want to review our practical considerations for LIN logging or our full LIN data logger intro. We hope you have enjoyed this intro to LIN bus. Please share, like, and subscribe, and check out our other guides on our channel and website.